Good afternoon. Thanks to the Autoimmunity Congress for this talk today. My name is Franziska Werner, and so welcome to my presentation of biomarker discovery for systemic lupus with engine protein arrays. First of all, I want to give you a short overview about the outcome of our experiment. We analyzed 29 serum samples of SLE patients with human protein arrays and detect IgG. We detect more than 2,500 antibody-antigen reactions in total. In more than 50% of the patients shows IgG against 70 antigens. You can see it in the right table. So we can say that we have a great output in this experiment with protein arrays. But why we start this project? I think to the audience of an autoimmunity congress, I don't have to explain that autoantibodies have a great potential as biomarkers. They play a role in systemic autoimmune disease as well as in cancer or infection diseases. We have a steady increase of autoimmune diseases, and there are more than 150 different diseases in this group. So we have to identify very specific biomarkers. But diseases often influence each other. So should we think in terms of disease classes, or we need a broader tool for biomarker discovery? Systemic lupus is a typical example for this problem. The immune system attacks the own tissue, which causes inflammation and tissue damage in skin, brain, lung, kidneys, and blood vessels. You can see it in the right picture. And because of the influence of the different tissues, the death causes of SLE are associated with active diseases like organ failure or infection. The causes is already unknown. So where to start with biomarker discovery in a case like this, which affects everything? For autoimmune diseases, it is obvious to start with autoantibodies as biomarkers. But what kind of biomarker we want to discover? SLE is difficult to diagnose in an early stage because the symptoms are very unspecific and unclear. So new biomarkers for diagnostic, prognostic, or risk factors are interesting. On the other side, we have no specific and personal treatment options. So biomarkers for therapy, response, and monitoring are also exciting. So if you have decide what is your target, there are many options for the method of discovery. On the first side, you have classic methods like Western blot or ELISA. These are bottom-up approaches, which are not unbiased, but you can get very clear data. On the other side, you have the top-down approaches like mass spectrometry and protein arrays. These are unbiased methods, so you are not focused on a very small and pre-selected antigen number, but you get a lot of data which have to be analyzed. In our experiment, we have chosen protein arrays as method. You can see it on the left side. It's a PVDF membrane with spotted E. coli clones, which express different human antigens, for example, full-length proteins, peptides, isoforms, fragments, and neoantigens. So you can investigate more than 10,000 human antigen in one experiment. So you have a very high chance for discovery. On the other side, the antigens cover a broad range of the human proteome. You can see it in the pie table. The tissue expression of the antigens range from brain, muscle, glands, and further. So it is an excellent tool for systemic diseases like SLE. The experimental setup workflow is very fast and very simple as Western blot. So we incubate 29 SLE patient samples and two self-reported healthy donor samples with the protein array. In the second step, we incubate a secondary antibody. In this case, it was an anti-human IgG antibody with an AP label. And in the last step, we incubate a substrate. After scan, the array looks like the picture in the middle. You have this bright spots, the positive hits, where the fluorescence intensity for both clone duplicates are higher than the background. and you can identify directly the antigen without additional sequencing. So in the end of the experiment, you have a list of the antigens of interest. In our experiment, we have no antigen which react with all SLE serum samples, but we have 70 different antigens which reacts in more than 50% of the SLE patient and not with the healthy donors. You can see it in the left picture. There are the 17 antigens. For example, the zinc finger protein MRC, which reacts in more than 83% of the patients. It is a biomarker in a pattern for SLE. The other case is TRIM21, which react in 52% of the patients. It is a published biomarker for SLE, so 15 antigens left as potential new biomarkers. So in the end, we can say protein arrays are an excellent tool for an unbiased start of biomarker discovery because you have a high discovery power, you need less samples, you have a huge data output, you test many human antigens in one shot, and you get your results very fast. But to identify the biomarker of interest, you need a very specific study design. So in follow-up experiments, you can compare biospecimens like serum and CSF of one patient. You can compare disease and treatment subclasses or disease stages like early and chronic. And you can compare autoantibody classes like IgM, IgG, or IgA. So there are still many things to consider and discover. So thanks for your attention. And if there are questions left, you can send me an email or a LinkedIn message.